Welcome back to Hellblade, Senua's Sacrifice. Oh yes, this looks like the lair of the illusory god. I think this is where we're gonna fight them. Wow, look at those rain effects and lightning and everything. So cool. There is a pathway up there.
Overcome Valravan's final illusion, the fearsome is keeping. I know you can do it, Senua. You have the sight.
We both see the darkness. We can fight it together.
Okay, so we're not quite there yet, but almost. So, can't go that way, huh? I think there was another way over here. Makes it passable down there to get on top of the tree. I think we're going to be walking on the tree.
Speak to me, Druth. Tell me a story.
Senua, listen. I will tell you the tale of a man called Findan. The Northmen captured Findan's sister, and his father sent him to pay for her release. But they took his gold, put him in chains, and held him for a day and a night without food or water. Then they released him. I don't know why. Upon his return, his father's enemies in Erin set fire to his home. His father burnt to death, and his brother was killed. But he escaped with sorrow in his heart. His father's enemies offered redress for his loss and invited him to a feast. It was at a hall near the sea. But when he went there, they betrayed him to the Northmen, who enslaved him and took him to hell. 6 years later, his slave masters landed on the shores of Orkney, burning all before them. And into that fire, Findan made his escape. What was Findan burnt away that day? But from the flames, a new man stepped forward, and Druth was born. Druth, the man that I am now. And though Findan never set eyes on his dear sister again, I, Druth, have found you, Senua.
I wish you could have seen my home before these dark times.
Oh, I bet I know what it is. I could probably get up the tree from this way, but I probably need to go back up there and switch that over. Now that I've unlocked the bridge, I don't need to take that other pathway. Yep, that's exactly it. Thank you. Giant bird's nest. The god takes the look of a bird. Is it their nest?
Broken. The gate is open.
Wait.
Open.
It's darkness. I know it from the wilds. It's coming back for me.
Didn't end well in the wilds. It never does. You think you can overcome the darkness, make sense of it, and once relief settles in, it strikes out of nowhere, throwing you helplessly back into the maelstrom, drowning the mind in fear, deeper, deeper, dragging you down so far into the void that maybe this time there is no coming back.
Help me.
But there,
help,
in the darkness,
Senua.
And she remembered what he told her.
Hear me. Reach out to me. Senua. Take my iron mirror. Look into it. For it is a window into the underworld. Within, you will see the face of the darkness that you fear. And if you focus, like I have taught you to, you will also see that as much as the darkness has you trapped within its veil, it too is trapped within yours. Focus! Focus! Focus!
I see you! I see you now! You led me to the wilds! You trapped me there!
Here we go. This one can be blocked.
Oh!
over.
Watch out! Sons, watch out!
He's stronger than you. They surrounded you.
Oh, am I down? Am I dead? Oh, that's new. Oof. So close.
Defend yourself.
I'm trying to dodge those, but I guess I should try to block them instead. This one's hard. Oof. Twice. That was maybe a bad time to do that. That was a terrible time to do that.
Thank you.
blocking it, but it still knocks me down. Alright, three of them. I'm gonna focus. Damn, I thought I focused. Didn't seem that focused.
To the gate to Helheim. Hold it in your mind's eye.
With every battle, the darkness grows stronger. Every victory, bringing her closer to defeat. Unfair, isn't it? In those dark winter nights in the wilds, there were times when she considered letting go. If it weren't for Druth, a chance encounter in the wilds, she would not have heard his stories of the Northmen. And she would not have this chance to find Dillian's soul. I'm coming.
So vibrant.
When she was younger, she would lay in the grass and stare at the clouds. And there she saw them. Elusive. Shifting faces. After a while, she could see the faces everywhere. The trees. The mountains. Caves.
We've seen one face so far, near the beginning of the game. I've probably missed some others.
I wonder. Can you see the faces too? They're there. If you look for them.
Senor. Mother? Senor, you have the sight. Just like I do. Once you can see into the underworld and all the souls within it will see you. Don't be afraid when they speak to you. I will always be here to guide you.
Did you see her? That was her mother, Galina. She was a priestess, a healer. She taught Senua to see the weave that binds the world together. And it was beautiful. It was a time before the darkness. But when it did come, it first came for her mother. Senua still sees her face from time to time, hidden in the world. Like she's still watching over. She misses her so much.
The mark of Valravn and the mark of Surt. You may cross the bridge over the River of Knives to Helheim.
Was this here before? I can't remember whether I've done it before. I probably have.
The Northmen say that in the beginning there was nothing but darkness.
Yes, I have.
Bitter cold to the north, fiery hot to the south. They say the cold formed ice, which melted from the sparks from the south. The power of the darkness gave life to the dripping ice.
So dark, it's dark, the darkness.
Only the dead may cross.
Only the dead may cross into hell.
There is no one here but me.
Not you.
Did you think that I would let you go? That you lost me back in the wilds? I will never let you go. You can't get rid of me. I am your shadow. And I will be watching when you draw your last dying gasp.
I'm not ready to die.
You will be when you see what they did to your dear beloved. Fury. and banish your fears. But in darkness they came. Through stormy black seas they raided these shores. Do you still hear his screams? And now that you're home, he's so far away. They've taken his soul. To these gods you cannot pray. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through his darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. You fought for love unspoilt by your darkness within. You fought for your dreams. Now there's no way to win. In the head of his corpse lies the seat of his soul. So you must carry his vessel to bring him back home. They can break you, but not your promise. Even death won't keep you apart. Through this darkness you will find him. In your sword still beats a heart. Everyone could see it in the hollows of your eyes. A gaze averted from life. You ran from it but brought it nearer. Led it to him. An endless suffering worse than death. And you wanted to surrender. Abandon and to find peace with the gods. No. The darkness won't allow it. So you will walk into the lair of the beast. Look it in the eye, and you will go to war. This is your mission. This is your quest. There is nothing else left.
Well, I think that's a pretty good place to end this episode. Whew. This game is really disturbing. I mean, it's just incredible pain and anguish and suffering. And that combined with incredibly vivid and detailed and in-your-face motion-captured acting. Oh, it's a lot. Alright, well, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, we will cross this bridge meant for only those who are dead.